for a little bit of backlight. Black ink after a brush thought I'm baptized. You can imagine a rush that ensue when you get three dimensions stuffed in a two. Then it's off to a school where it's all the you do, being trained and observed by a capable few. Back in New York by peeps and a dog in a two-bedroom doing menial jobs. Plus rhyming and stealing and being a clod. Distractions, freedom, a rod. I left some years of giving a light. I left some will the spirit away. I let my fears materialize. I let my skills deteriorate. Horned about a thought of what I should have been. Continuing a mission that was rooted in a 20-year affinity and rickety condition with an ID crisis. Snap on the front lawn, look up in the sky, it's
shapes falling out of the fringe. All heart though we would have made cowardly kings. They will chop you down just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. Just to count your.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we've got a pair of running backs. We're hoping for plenty of touches to come their way.
All right, Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Tonight, it's a preseason matchup between the New Orleans Saints and the New England Patriots. Danny Amendola on the return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. First down. And his first look is incomplete. Danny Amendola, that was the intended target, and that'll make it second and 10. On the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one. They're just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. They'll run again with Blunt. Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first.
A good explosive run there sets him up with a new set of downs, and every team wants to start their game with a really nice drive. Three and out. No one wants to see that, and they were able to avoid it after that run.
On first down, Brady. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Keenan Lewis, and his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. He goes underneath to Ingram. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
Give Arts on that one. It earns him a fresh set. Downs. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. And the ball carrier there, Mark Ingram, in his sixth season now with the Saints.
Yet to have a 1,000-yard season, but any guy who wins the trophy, you know the potential is always there.
Yeah, but you're right. Yet to get to 1,000. Had 769 last year in 12. Second down, Ingram. And he'll get inside the 40 to maybe the 38-yard line. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And he's got Snead. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He lost four there, and it's third down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Now Breeze on third down. He's got time, and there's a flag on the play. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Here's Connor Barth for the field goal try. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. And Barth puts it through. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. Well, it's a night game, a lot of energy in this building. But the visiting team here, they get the ball on the opening drive, and they find a way to at least produce three.
And things are just getting started, so you can't say that they've taken the momentum totally, but a good start towards seizing it in this game.
And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So second and 10 here. Blunt, the lone running back. And they'll give it to him here. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make the run as we just saw there.
And he'll have his man. That's Edelman. It's a gain of 17, and it'll give him a first down. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
To throw, it's Brady. On the crossing route, that's caught. Julian Edelman. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. And just one tick to go, so this will obviously be the final play of this first quarter. Throwing on first down is Brady. And he slings one that's incomplete. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move as they face a second down here. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will actually break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Manziel. Washington's got it. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll be fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So it's a sloppy beginning for him. An interception on their opening drive and now a missed field goal here on drive number two.
Doesn't feel like they've shown up yet. It's been a very flat start. And against a team like this, you just can't let that happen.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like the way you're thinking. Because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it, touchdowns.
Here's Spiller. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. McCown looks to throw on third. And he locates Josh Hill, complete. A gain of 11 and a first down.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. Let's see what the offense comes with here, second and eight.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well, because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Josh Hill, 52 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead.
I know guys who design defenses, they try to prepare for everything. But you ignore the guy who plays tight end at your own peril.
Yeah, and he's like having another wide receiver out there sometimes, right?
Exactly right, because they're such a matchup nightmare, and they're hybrid guys. Are they receivers? Are they big guys that block? How about the one we just saw there? Catch it and go. Run after catch all the way into the end zone.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out on the field. Now, they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out? Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
McCown to throw on second down. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
Now the eight-year man out of SMU, Thomas Morstead, on to kick it away. There, this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They try again with Lewis. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. On the stop, Stephon Anthony with a tackle.
And while there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Football's such a game of tendencies, down in distance, and on third and inches, third and one. You're thinking, yeah, the fullback's probably going to get the ball, but when you get to third and two, most of the time, that's either the running back or a pass play. So that's a nice tendency breaker by the offensive team there. Handing to their big guy to pick up a first down.
And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
All right, here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Now Manziel. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Build it on the back line of the end zone. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. Now the Patriot offense sent it for again. They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. And he's brought down. Give him 16 on the pickup. And it gives the Pats a first down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Again, it's Lewis. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run. And it's second and four. Now Lewis. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. A 3-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. This is Lewis. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. On the sneak, it's Manziel.
It seems like, and it is a gamble on their side of the field, but they have supreme confidence in picking it up on a quarterback sneak. You can just feel it from this team.
Here's Manziel. And his pass incomplete. The veteran Nate Washington, the man he was looking for. And it'll be second and 10.
Well, partner, so much for the mismatch. How about the guy at the second level, that big linebacker, able to run with the receiver and make a play on the football?
Here we go now.
They run. This is Lewis. And he's got it across midfield and down to about the 47-yard line. That second down run, a big help. The 7 yards leaves him with just a third and three now. Now they'll run with Lewis. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
So the Patriots will turn it over to their left-footed punter. That's Ryan Allen to kick it away. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year. As we'll send you down the coast. Never mind, Larry, forget your halftime report. Apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. On the return, here's C.J. Spiller. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The D for the Pats. The Patriots heading back onto the field now. Their stay on the field last time was short-lived with a 3-and-out. See if they can get some more of that.
And ordinarily, you want to be on the field playing, right? But 3-and-out? That's almost gold to a defense. Get to the bench. Get some rest. Turn the ball over to your offense.
We'll see what they can do here. See if they can force another 3-and-out. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And the offense lining up first and 10.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
It's a gain of 24 that time, and that leads to a New Orleans first down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard. In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end-of-the-half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you. Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. Let's go! From the gun on third, McCown. And this is going to be incomplete. The tight end Josh Hill was the target. And that'll bring up fourth down. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And Barth puts it through. And the lead now increases to 20 to nothing. So put another three on the board, and all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the third quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start. And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Sheldon Rankins, the rookie from Louisville, in there to bring him down for a loss of seven. Back to throw. Looking downfield for Dobson. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. The Saints with an extra defensive back here on third on the field.
Could they blitz?
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A very solid gain of 27.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And his throw here is incomplete. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect that.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was trying to go to Aaron Dobson that time. And it'll be third and 10 now.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. And quickly, they get to the line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis taking it in. And the Patriots get a score closer.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
McCown will try again on second down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
It'll be a gain of 4, and that's going to make it fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll kick it away for the second time.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. So the Patriots coming out now. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up.
And now the up man has it. It's a fake. And he'll cut it out to the sideline. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. It's a big play that time on the fake punt. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. So they snap it straight to the up man. What's his responsibility? Normally, obviously, just to protect, but he's got to be a guy that can be pretty agile too, right?
Yeah, without a doubt, because you're talking about a guy, even in protection, he may have to slide up and down the line of scrimmage to pick up someone who comes through trying to block him.
Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Manziel. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. But it's brought in by Washington. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. And a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy in the game right now.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Well, sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, two-score game, second half. You're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
And I could get much better than this for an opportunity.
And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the one. He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. And now before they run this play on fourth and one, we're going to get a break and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the six here on fourth and goal. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Johnny Manziel taking it in. And the Patriots are back within a score. So they went for it from the one on fourth and goal, and they got it done.
Is this the new NFL?
This is the new NFL.
This is the updated NFL, and I like it. I know that quarterbacks across the league have spent the entire offseason and even during the season lobbying their coaches to go for it more on fourth down. Let's go get it. Because nowadays, you've got to score points to win games in the NFL. You can't just rely on your defense to hold them.
I think the quarterbacks want to eliminate field goals inside of 30 yards, probably.
Well, listen, they have enough confidence in themselves that they can call plays and make plays that they won't need those field goals inside the 30.
And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. He's got time in the pocket. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. Now he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Oh, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Now the Patriots offense, they worked their way back out onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
In the red zone this time. Push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
All right, here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard.
Well, you know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
And that was a nice play. He knocked it away, but obviously you want the interception in this situation. You want to take away any chance and they have any decision to make on fourth down. But things happen so quickly in the end zone in this compressed area of the field that you're just happy to knock it away and not allow a touchdown.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal.
We just totally get the sense there that a field goal was not in the game plan at all.
And the boys up front, they created the surge. I think they knew that they had the leverage advantage.
Oh, that's a great point there. Being able to get lower than the defensive front, create just enough space. And I love when those quarterbacks get low and slide in there and get it done.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Roman Harper the one who picks it. And nothing there on the return. They've got the football, but they'll have to start this drive at their own 4-yard line. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And they'll begin this drive with C.J. Spiller. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. The fourth quarter here, they got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Spiller. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Hurry up, here we go.
Again on the ground, again it's Spiller. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. So the offense looking at a second and 8.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves. And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Well, Charles, there's an old saying, don't let a loss beat you twice.
You're exactly right about that, Brandon. When you look at it and all of your preparation went into winning this week, now you have to absorb a loss and find a way to shake it off.
clock is broken. Never stopping, never slowing. Yeah, we're living wide open. Unwinding every moment. Like the clock is broken. Never stopping, never slowing. Yeah, we're living wide open.
Save my soul. I can feel it coming, troubles in the air.